Hi everyone, I'm Karin Debacher. I'm a project manager for executive board projects and business development at HHLA. And I'm excited to be invited here today, and I'll give you a short presentation what who HHLA is, and afterwards I'll give you an introduction to our hydrogen strategy. If, for those of you who've not heard of HHLA, HHLA or Hamburger Hafen and Logistics AG is a European logistics and port company. The city of Hamburg holds 69% of shares in HHLA, and the remaining 30% are in free float. Our activities span from the port of Hamburg to many other parts in Europe. In general, our portfolio covers the entire transport chain. So we are mostly known for our port handling facilities, but we also operate a comprehensive intermodal network and offer various services around logistics, container services, and also information and data, such as drone services or additive manufacturing. Our port operations, we operate three container terminals in the port of Hamburg, and also a multi-purpose terminal and a bulk terminal. In addition, we also operate a terminal in Tallinn in Estonia, in Odessa in the Ukraine, and in Trieste in Italy. And as you can see in this slide, we operate a comprehensive intermodal network where we connect European seaports with industrial regions in the European hinterland, especially in Central, Eastern, and Southeastern Europe. So between these locations, we offer more than 600 weekly connections between the seaports and the industrial regions. And in addition, we also operate 17 inland terminals within this network. So this makes us also the market leader for intermodal transport in this region. In addition, we also operate truck transport, such as regional transport, also long distance transport. Yeah, with that being said, in addition to the continued development of our core business and tapping into further business fields, sustainability and climate protections are integral parts of our business model. And with that being said, and also the reason we are all here today, hydrogen plays a big role in following through on this ambition. And for that, we have set up a hydrogen strategy, which is mainly based on two pillars. We have the consumption side, where we see ourselves as a hydrogen consumer, and also the transport and import side. And the idea is that both pillars are connected, and we link both pillars together for our hydrogen strategy. But I will now explain the two pillars more in depth. And I will start with our role as a hydrogen consumer. Yeah, the reason we see ourselves as a hydrogen consumer is that we as HHLA have set ourselves a very ambitious climate protection goal. We aim to make the entire HHLA group climate neutral by 2040. And we've also set ourselves an interim goal, that is, we want to halve our CO2 emissions by 2030. And in order to achieve that, hydrogen plays a big role in achieving this goal. The reason is that we operate a lot of heavy-duty vehicles on our terminals. And you can see some pictures of the vehicles that we operate. For example, on the left bottom side, you see a straddle carrier. Some of you might recognize it from the movie Star Wars, they look very similar. And they lift and transport heavy containers. And we also have reach deckers or empty container handlers. You can see them at the top right side, and other vehicles such as forklifts, terminal trucks, and also trucks. And today, all these vehicles, or most of these vehicles, run on diesel. And as we want to decarbonize our operations, we see a lot of potential in hydrogen and fuel cell technology for these types of equipment. The only difficulty is that most of these types of equipment are not available as fuel cell equipment yet. So this is why we have set up a three-phase approach, And the idea is that in our first phase that we call phase zero, and you can see these three phases on the left-hand side of the presentation, we plan to build a test center for fuel cell vehicles. And the idea is that together with the manufacturers of these vehicles, we plan to develop and test these vehicles on one of our terminals in Hamburg. And the idea is to test prototypes. And once these prototype types have been successfully tested, we plan to proceed to phase one. And that's where we plan to operate more than 100 heavy-duty fuel cell vehicles on our terminals in Hamburg. And for this phase one, the project is called H2Load. And for this project, we have also been nominated by the German government to be named an important project of common European interest. And we are currently in the process and in the European matchmaking process and hope to be officially named a important project of common European interest soon. And the idea is after we have successfully completed the first phase and the second, the phase one, it's actually the second phase, we plan to proceed to phase two and roll the concept that we have developed in Hamburg. We plan to roll that out to our other European locations to decarbonize all of our terminals. Yes. And as I said before, we plan to link our role as a consumer with our role as a hydrogen transporting and importing company. And for this, we are currently implementing several demonstration projects, but we are also preparing for large-scale implementation. And yeah, most of you probably heard that there is currently an ongoing debate on how the hydrogen will be transported. So we have, of course, have the pipeline option, and also regarding the maritime transport, you can transport the hydrogen as liquefied hydrogen, as compressed hydrogen, as ammonia, and as a liquefied organic hydrogen carrier. And yeah, and we think that all options, or that there will be room for different types of options. And we are, as I said, involved in different demonstration projects to evaluate the different options, also regarding the transport of these options in containers. But we are also at the same time preparing for large scale import infrastructure and import terminals. To add to that, we think that, or in our view, it is important that the import of hydrogen does not stop at the seaports, because a lot of consumers are not located close to European seaports, and they so that the hydrogen has to be transported to the European hinterland. And of course, for that, pipelines will play a big role in that, but we think that there's still potential, or that some consumers have different requirements. And for them, transport, for example, via intermodal network is a very valuable addition to a hydrogen network. Yeah, and now I'm coming to my last slide, and just want to add that building a hydrogen supply chain cannot be done alone. And we are very interested in partnering up with other interested companies to develop hydrogen supply chains. And one example where we are already doing that is the Hamburg Hydrogen Alliance. The idea of the Hamburg Hydrogen Alliance is that we have built up a consortium where the whole hydrogen value chain is concentrated within a very dense space. And we have, in this alliance, we have hydrogen producers, hydrogen infrastructure providers, and also hydrogen consumers, such as Airbus, such as Arcelor, Mittal, and also other mobility, logistics, and maritime consumers. And the idea is that in this alliance, we build kind of like a blueprint for other hydrogen hubs within the hydrogen network, so that we have a dense hub to start with, and then transfer it to other hydrogen hubs all over. Yeah, and with that, I'm at the end of my presentation. Please let me know if you have any questions, and also if you see potentials for synergies. As I said, we are very interested in cooperating with others. So kindly get in touch if you have any questions, if you have any ideas, please let me know. And yeah, I'm looking forward to your questions. Thank you.
Thank you, Ms. Debacher.